my last concert, 2003, that was crazy. It was, you know, I performed my biggest single, Eat, Sleep, Repeat, to open with MC Hammer, which that was great. And I just got such a large applause there. And it was really, it was a surreal moment. The quiet kid has come to stay. What did he say? Hey, guys.
Hey, Joe. Can I call you Joe?
I prefer Sir or Mr. Godar, but yeah. Welcome to my crib.
It's nice to meet you.
You too.
Yeah, this is a nice place you have here.
Yeah, thank you.
Is this...
Pride and joy. So yeah, I was just about to make some breakfast, if you guys want to follow me into the kitchen here. Just a typical breakfast at Casa del Godar. Let's see here. You know.
What's that?
Ramen noodles.
No, cinnamon.
Yeah. It sweetens it a little bit, you know. So yeah.
So really tell us a little bit about what you've been up to since you kind of disappeared.
You know, just sort of trying to find my roots, you know, coming back to my city of home, you know.
Sure, yeah.
Yeah, playing music on the streets.
What kind of music do you play?
Oh, all kinds. Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, you know, the kids love it, you know.
Where do you usually head for busking?
The Del Mar Loop is really my main haunt.
Oh,
it's really where I do my best work.
Yeah,
this is enough of this for now. So yeah, I like my ramen noodles uncooked for breakfast. I don't really have water anymore, so yeah, I just sort of keep them uncooked. I found some cinnamon behind a garage one time that someone threw out, I'm not sure. I tried to take the cinnamon challenge. That didn't entirely work, so I ended up spitting it out on my ramen noodles because I did this in the morning when I was about to eat my uncooked. And so it spilled all over it. And I was like, oh, well, how can I eat this now? But it was all I had to eat. And so I was like, oh, hey, well, I've got some leftover milk I found behind a prison. So I poured that in there and I mixed it all up and it was actually quite delicious. Hey, guys. So basically, after I eat my breakfast and everything, I like to, you know, get a few reps in on the old basketball hoop and everything. You know.
Did some of your songwriting come out here?
Yeah.
Are you writing a lot of music these days?
Oh, you know, not really. I do mostly covers on the street of classics, you know. Sure. Classics being greats like Twinkle Twinkle Little Star and songs of those that are wonderful for all ages. That's pretty sweet. Has been since high school. Not gonna lie.
Did you go to high school?
Yeah, for a little bit.
How long?
Like a month. I had kicked out something about like absent too much, and there was actually school on Wednesdays, which I didn't know. I thought that was like the break day, but apparently so. It was a cold winter evening, November 11th, 1986. It was the first day my mother ever smiled until I looked at her, and then I punched her in the face, which was odd because I was so tiny, I packed a wallop. I was a super child. And so that began 27 years of animosity between myself and my mother. After performing Madison Square Garden, there was the after party. We all know what happened there. My illegitimate child, Joe Jr., was conceived. One of the proudest and most shameful moments of my life. Court case, Joe Godar versus the Supreme Court, 2007. Basically, it was fighting for my illegitimate child to live under my custody, which I did not win, obviously. I'm not sure how it made it to the Supreme Court.
So we did some research on the house, and in the phone book, it's actually listed under an Adam Peterson. Could you tell us about that?
Yes, Adam Peterson, that's the name in the phone book for this house. Adam Peterson, he's a very close personal friend of mine, who, when I was buying this house, and I didn't want to put my name under it because, you know, I didn't want the paparazzi or anyone to know where I live, because obviously, you know, I'm famous. So Adam was like, hey, well, you can just register it under my name, and then no one will know. So that's what I did, and yeah, I've been here for 7 years uninterrupted.
So this house is entirely your house then?
Yeah, this is completely my house. I don't think Adam Peterson's ever even set foot in it before.
Dude!
What? Adam,
dude, what on earth are you doing in my house?
What are you doing here?
Where did you even come from?
I thought you were still in Tijuana.
Are you kidding me? I haven't been there since, like, 2011.
What? I thought you were still there.
No.
Where have you been?
In my house.
Why
haven't
I seen
you? Where have you been? Have you been in my house this whole time?
Well, I've known Joe, I think, we started collaborating together, back in the late 90s. Like, I believe it was 97 when I first met him. It was at our record label, Capitol. We were working together as recording managers, and I was like, hey, you jam? And he was like, yeah, I jam a little. I also eat and sleep. And I said, okay, let's record an album together. That's what we did. What's most interesting about him is that he has almost no talent when it comes to music. I don't think I will press charges. We had a little talk about it. I think he agreed to ask me the next time he comes into my house. And honestly, I would press charges, but I wouldn't make anything. Joe is absolutely bankrupt.
2006, I got this email from Aziz Akwali, I believe his name was, who said he was a Nigerian king begging for money, and he just knew about my gracious heart, and I can't even describe it, really, but it hit me hard, right here. And so I forked over the $600 million, and I never heard from him or saw it again, but I feel that it went to a big cost. I thought I could make it back, you know, performing, but when you're a 23-year-old instead of a teen, singing your teen hits from the 1990s that nobody knew about, you don't make a lot of money. And so I made about $100 in 2 years performing in 16 locations. So I decided to call it quits, file for bankruptcy, 2008. After I do a little warm-up with the basketball and all that stuff, I like to get to the real strenuous exercise workout with WeFit Plus. I like to set low standards for myself. That way I get to keep it. Real workout begins on WeFit Plus. Really, really gets me nice and toned. Gained 6 pounds of muscle because of it. What? I've been playing Guitar Hero for a very long time, ever since really after I was sort of pushed out of the music business after my last concert in 2003. It's really been my coping mechanism. It's to the point now where I know how to play the guitar in Guitar Hero better than I can play any real instrument in real life. I can show you guys some of the stuff I've been working on lately, right here.
Got it, yeah. Love that. Sorry, excuse me. Oh, I have to take this. Excuse me. Hello? Yes. Hi. This is Clint Baxter from Allstate. Thank you for calling me back. Yeah, I was just calling. Maybe if you were to, I was wondering if you wanted to switch insurance plans, maybe. Yeah. No? No, Jennifer, I can't talk right now, okay? I just can't do this with you. Sorry, Jennifer, she's insane. Excuse me.
What are we gonna do at the Loop?
We're gonna busk a little bit. Maybe make some money, hopefully.
Make some money. Are you bringing any instruments with you?
Yeah, I've got a guitar. It's gonna be pretty intense, I'm not gonna lie.
What songs are you planning on playing?
We'll see. There's this one alley that, it doesn't get a ton of attention, but when it does, they're normally either really, rich criminals who have, a ton of money to throw at me, or, bums who don't give me anything, but...
Okay, so you're gonna be playing in an alley.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you have any concerns about that? Well, no, it's a left turn. Left turn.
Joe. Yeah.
How much do you make per year from gigs like this?
Per year? Gigs like this? I don't really consider it a gig, since it's just me on my own, I don't know. Probably per year... Maybe $50.
$50.
On a good year.
So that averages to less than a dollar a day. More like 33 cents a day?
Yeah, something like that.
Okay, that's not too bad.
It's pretty lucrative.
Is this your main source of income?
I wouldn't necessarily say that. I mean, there are other ways, sources of income I have. Can't really talk about them.
Yeah, I understand.
Some of them, they aren't exactly what you might call legal, if you know what I mean. So this is my typical performing gear. Big Batman fan,
You hiding your identity?
Yeah. you know, don't really want people to know that great Joe Godar has turned to street performing in alleys. So yeah, I actually had one of these stars, but they took it down when I went bankrupt for some reason. Just whenever you're ready.
I'm ready.
Alright. This is a little one for the kids. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. It's one of my personal favorites. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high. Like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Thank you. That was good, right? I nailed it. Yeah, high point of my career, I would have to say, my 1998 album, Stomach Rumblings. It was inspired directly after I went 4 straight hours without snacking at all. So it got pretty deep into my inner thoughts and my heart. This is really spreading out.
How much money have you made?
Looks like about a few dollars. No. Solid 60 cents so far. So it's going pretty well.
How'd you pay for that guitar?
You know, I just saved up. Definitely didn't take it from Adam Peterson's house, that's for sure.
What were some other jokes that we planned that we might not have done? Did I miss anything? No, I'm sorry. We didn't know that you were going to make a comeback tour. Could you tell us about this?
Yeah, well, it's not really, legitimate, I believe is the term right now. But that's my plan.